Hey, I'm Jonathan, and this is Rad-head. Today I'm building this spinning water tank that demonstrates the effect of the centrifugal force by creating this cool convex shape. Let's start building. I started by making the tank itself. I've cut some 4mm clear acrylic into two rectangles and four thin strips that will make the edges of the tank. I assembled the tank and held it together with spring clamps. Once pleased with how everything aligned, I fused the sides together with acrylic solvent. Ideally, I would have used a thinner solvent that will actually weaken to the seam, but this is all I had. I mixed a cup of water with a few drops of green food coloring for extra contrast. Once the tank is fully cured, I started filling it up. First, I marked the desired water level, which is halfway up the tank, and used the syringe to fill it up to that line. Now it's time to add the last piece of acrylic and seal this water tank for good. There's no going back from this point. This thin water tank needs to spin freely, but it has such a low moment of inertia, it won't hold the spin very well. So I decided to make the tank holder from a heavy chunk of steel that will make it spin much longer. I milled a 12mm slot in the middle of the steel blank for the water tank to securely sit in. Machining steel always makes me think how crazy it is to cut a piece of steel with just another piece of steel that is slightly harder. The harder material always wins. I flipped the piece around and drilled an 8mm hole partway through. Instead of using all the fancy gauges on the machine, I just marked the depth with a piece of blue tape. I then gave it a couple of coats of white spray paint. I've cut a piece of 8mm shaft to length with my angle grinder. By the way, I ended up using a 15cm long shaft, not 10, as you see me cut here. Now it's time to make the base for this whole contraption. I wanted something heavy that will easily support the rotating mass, so I decided to cast it out of concrete. I still need to somehow attach a couple of bearings to it in order for the tank to spin freely, and I decided to embed this 3D printed bearing holder in the concrete mold, which is just a plastic cereal bowl. I prepped my work area before starting the messy part of the casting, giving it the final touch, and let's mix some concrete. I mixed the concrete following my grandma's famous recipe. One part white cement, 2 parts sand, 1 part plaster, which makes the concrete cure faster, and grandma's secret ingredient, diluted PVA glue. I mixed the dry ingredients thoroughly and added the glue and some water until I got to the consistency of gluten-free oatmeal. I carefully filled the mold using the steering stick to push the concrete into every nook and cranny. I then used the power sander to vibrate out any air bubbles. I noticed that the mold started rotating counterclockwise when vibrated. It seems that no matter what I try, I can't seem to make it rotate clockwise. I'll have to look deeper into this one. If you have any ideas, feel free to comment. I leveled the top part with a straight edge, and now this needs to cure for 24 hours. If you're impatient like me, you can simply put it in the oven on high heat for 10 minutes. I'm kidding, of course. Or am I? Demolding the base reveals a very smooth surface. Although I still had some bubbles on one side. I was very pleased by how the bearing holder was integrated into the concrete. I intentionally made the holes a little tight, so I lightly heated the part to get a really snug fit. I assembled everything together by first inserting the water tank into the steel holder. Then, I slipped a small piece of tube on the shaft to act as a stopper. Now, I can finally place the tank on top and give it a spin. The tank spins freely and takes quite a long time to come to a rest, thanks to the extra mass of the steel holder. I played with different ways of spinning it, and found that I can reach very high speeds by wrapping a string over the shaft and pulling it quickly. You could calculate the RPM of the water tank by examining the obtained curve. I plan to do exactly that, including a pseudo-rigorous analysis of the physics behind this demonstration, on my next video, so stay tuned. Off camera, I made 2 more water tanks. The water level in these tanks revealed the full 3D surface created by the rotating liquid. The cylinder gives a very clear view of this surface. My original tank simply displays a cross-section of it. The cube, however, lacks the continuous rotational symmetry, and the edges are further apart than the faces. This gives it its unique look. However, this is of course still the same surface as with the other tanks. That's all for this one. Feel free to comment below, I'd love to know what you think about this project. As always, I have plans and 3D printable models over on my website, the link is in the description. If you like my project and want to help me make more of them, consider supporting me on Patreon. Until next time, bye.